Hey, Raz Ballers, it's Nick from my soon-to-be former beach house. You can see right behind me here, I'm literally in the process of packing up because in 8 days, I'm moving down to Phoenix so we can start Raz Ball Radio on May the 1st. Now, I've never claimed to be an expert. That's what the guys at Raz Ball are for. I'm here to really drive the bus or the Sprinter van, whatever. So this year, with everything that's been going on, I really have to cram for my draft. So we thought we'd do a video post on some tips to keep in mind if you are doing last minute prep for drafts coming up in the next week and a half. So first thing that we're gonna talk about is not messing up your first round pick. Okay, so we're gonna look at it from a few different spots in that round. If you're at the top of the draft, and what I'm gonna tell you now, I actually practice what I preach, because in the Raz Ball Writers League, I took Miguel Cabrera over Mike Trout. Only reason I did that is because Trout's value is so tied to his speed. Now, he might go 30-50 this year, and that would be very exciting, and he's fun to watch, but you know what? I know what I'm going to get from Miguel Cabrera, so I would take the safety of Cabrera with that first overall pick. As the round progresses, I get more and more nervous. Reason is that Chris Davis, I'm worried about regression. Carlos Gonzalez, one of my favorite players to watch, but he's missed an average of 38 games per year the last 3 years. That is a lot of risk tied to your first round pick. Also, not a big Cano fan. Look at his home road splits before this season, last season, and he didn't do well outside of Yankee Stadium. So, how is he gonna do in Seattle? I just don't get it. I've got him penciled in for 20 homers and a 300 average, which makes him kind of Buster Posey. So I'm not wasting a first round pick on him. However, I am going after Prince Fielder, going after Joey Votto, going after Bryce Harper, especially Fielder in Arlington. And if you're pushing towards the end of the round and you could wind up with a combination of those three guys, I think you'd set yourself up really well for success going through the rest of your draft. Second tip. Hey, by the way, Kyle the intern, I need like some water. Can you give me a glass of water or something? Jeez Louise, you're fired. Second tip, if you're cramming for your draft, avoid prospects. And I know it's fun to try and find this year's Jose Fernandez, but especially as the draft goes into later rounds, give me veterans. You know what? Adam Dunn, he's not a guy you want on your fantasy team because he's an average drain and he's probably going to platoon. But you know what? He's going to hit 25 to 30 homers. I'd rather have him on my bench than a guy who might not be up in the majors come middle of May. If you really are looking for prospects, though, definitely check out all the prospect information at razball.com. A couple guys that might be fantasy relevant because of some recent news. One with the injury to Profar and the fact that Elvis Andrus is having forearm tightness. Okay, look, I'm not saying Tommy John, but it does happen to position players sometimes. Keep an eye, I gotta pronounce this right. Rugned Odor, O-D-O-R. He's a Venezuelan prospect, 20 years old, really talented, power speed, middle infielder. Scouting prospect is projecting him for a late 2014 ETA, but I think there's a chance he could crack that middle infield in Texas this year. So he is a name to go and keep an eye on. I picked him up in the Raz Ball Writers League this morning, actually. Another name that you could keep an eye on is Archie Bradley of the Diamondbacks with the injury to Corbin. Bradley, if he gets a chance, he's fighting for the fifth starter role, could actually be really useful this year. So a couple names if you're looking for a quick cheat sheet. Number three, grab some horses at the top of your rotation. Typically, my first 9, 10, 11 picks, I'm going to normally grab one starter. This year, I'm going way beyond that. I'm getting a second, maybe even a third in that first dozen. And I think it's because we're entering the post-PED era in baseball and pitchers are dropping like flies. So I think you're still going to be able to take advantage if you really work the wire and find pitching late this year. With that said, I think it's going to be a lot more work than normal. So just one thing to consider. Tip number four, use the Raz Ball War Room. Right there. Raz Ball War Room is one of the best tools we have, and it's not, you need to use this, people, because what this is as you're actually drafting, you go to razball.com/draft, and you can actually input the players as they're coming along, and it gives you your totals. So that's a great way, especially again, if you're not plugged in this year, to make sure you're hitting all your categories. Also, at razball.com, under the tools icon, there is the Hittertron, the Streaminator, the player cards, it's all there. Lots of really good tools that Rudy has put together. We don't keep them tied up in the basement for nothing, so take advantage. Next week, we'll also do a post on really how to maximize stuff like the Hittertron and Streaminator throughout the season. So come back and see us next Monday. Tip number 5, go pay for saves. Check. But you know what? Your penance for having not done any prep, you probably should go grab one closer this year, high-end closer. It is kind of a bit of a waste, but if you're not ready and you haven't been following the bullpen developments that's been happening this offseason, might not be a bad strategy to use. A couple guys that Smokey is looking out for, if you have a late round pick that you're looking at, any Farquhar from Seattle, not sure what's going on in that situation, but he's a really talented pitcher with lots of Ks. Also keep an eye on Nick Vincent from San Diego, as well as Steve Delabar from Toronto. Also, Sergio Santos had a really good spring for the Jays this year. So he was crazy good a couple years ago for the White Sox. So keep an eye on him. Number 6, avoid buzzy names. Yeah, you know what? Danny Salazar and Zach Wheeler, their stuff is dirty, but so is the price you have to pay for them. You can get guys like Kuroda, Buchholz, and AJ Burnett 4 to 6 rounds later. I'd be a lot more comfortable with that person. Number 7. 7? 7. Every year we tell you to hold off on catcher, especially in 10 and 12 team leagues that just use one catcher. This year's a perfect example of it. You got to go get Buster Posey or Joe Mauer in the 3rd or 4th round. Yeah, they play some first base, which is nice, but you can get guys like Wilson Ramos and Evan Gattis like a dozen rounds later. Hold off on catcher this year. There's 12 to 14 catchers who should contribute on a regular basis. Tip number 8. I got to count. It's the metric system. It's totally messing me up in Canada. All right, number 8. Second and third base don't have the normal depth they do this year. Well, second base usually doesn't have depth, but nonetheless, this year I think it's particularly weak. So I've gone a little bit above to get guys like Kinsler and Ryan Zimmerman this year, especially Ryan Zimmerman. I'm just waiting for that one healthy season where he puts it all together in that lineup. Might be this year. If you miss on guys like that later on, you can get Daniel Murphy, you could get Kyle Seager, but definitely not a lot of depth at those positions. Speaking of Daniel Murphy, he was really useful last year. He's getting no love. You can get him in the 15th round, so another guy to keep an eye on. To that extent of second and third base, also, Matt Carpenter gets second and third base eligibility in both Yahoo and ESPN this year, and Jed Jerko also gets both positions in Yahoo. So they could be really versatile for you, again, at those really weak positions. Tip number nine. Most important thing you can do, get an intern, okay? To like get you coffee and show up late and get the wrong order and all that. Kyle, the intern, come over here, buddy. This is Kyle Orvis. We call him number 8, Orvi in the corner. Yep. He's done a lot of work with Razzball this year. Hey, buddy, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. You still thinking about maybe coming on this tour with us in August?
Of course, definitely.
You know you're going to have the worst jobs possible. You understand that, right?
Yeah, it makes sense.
And you haven't met Gray yet. He's pretty tough on the on the interns.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, okay, good stuff. Well, we'll see how he does. Orvi, number 8. What else we got? Oh, by the way, you're fired for not setting my rosters for the Australian game. Okay, gotcha. Get out of here. So that's what we got, guys. If you want to leave a comment, I will do my best to get back to you on it. We'll see you on the podcast today. Also, too, Jay Rong has been kind enough to do a little video after this for you. If you've already done your draft, what are things you should be looking to do right now? And it's great. It's Jay Rong, so it's very emo. And hold on, here's my Jay Rong impression. I haven't dated a girl in a long time, so I drink whiskey. What was that? Was that good?
That was good. That was nice. Good.
I like that. Okay. So yeah. Hey, by the way, you go to college, man. Like, get some girls for Jay.
I'll work on it.
See you on the podcast, guys.
Welcome. I'm Jay. You probably know me as Jay Wrong, the wrong in parentheses. And I guess this is to help you if you wanted to touch a girl's boobs, or in my case, a ghost's boobs. I'm not even sure if that's how you do it anymore. It's been a while for me. Probably the last fiscal year. But anyways, we're here to go over some things you should do after you've drafted. Now, I know Nick has just gone over some things that you should do before drafting, but I know some drafts have happened, so you probably are wondering what to do right now between your naps and going to Pornhub.com. So, first of all, you want to keep a microscope on all the bullpen situations that are happening right now. I mean, a good example we saw the other day, Aroldis Chapman. he decided to play chicken with a 450 mile per hour comebacker. So now we have something called J.J. Hoover in line to get saves. I mean, who would have thunk it? So you want to keep an eye on the pitchers in spring training specifically. Anything can happen at any time. Obliques can explode. Arms can completely turn into dust. And that's just me talking about Matt Kemp. So, you know, things can happen. Something else you want to do, which is sort of related to the last thing, is, you know, be very reactive to spring training news. You know, anything that comes out, it's probably the opposite advice before you're drafting, because you kind of get stuck into this hype machine. But guys like, you know, Ventura, Baez, maybe even an Archie Bradley, you know, while during the draft, you're probably fighting hype. If you've already drafted, you need to go and grab these guys now. Those guys are probably already taken, but guys like them. You know, you have a bench for a reason. That's the stash, high risk, high reward. And young guys who might be able to help you out, you know, it'll be there for streamer options if you need it. But those are the spots. Anybody, I can guarantee you, anybody on your bench right now is expendable to a degree. Also, use your DL as well as you can. Right now, I think you're seeing some guys become DL eligible. Someone like Derek Holland. You know, make sure he's not on your free agent wire. If you see him, grab him. I mean, these are a few months that you'll have to wait, but maybe the reward will be there. And probably the last important thing you want to do right now is trade early and trade often. This is probably the last chance you have when player prices are going to be stable. They're going to be static. As soon as the season starts, everything happens, and you don't know what's going to happen next, except Tulowitzki will be out until All-Star break. That's about the only for sure thing. So it's about value building during that time. You know, especially if you see an auto draft team playing on the waiver wire, target them for trades. I mean, drafting Jacoby Ellsbury in the first round, having 9 starting pitchers with half of them named Chris Medlin and Jared Parker and Patrick Corbin, you know, this is probably a traumatic experience for them. You want to get in there, check to see if there's a deal, or at the very least, be a friend and see if he's suffering from a concussion from drafting that type of team. So those are some things you can do after your draft, you know, and just enjoy it. You've probably completed the hardest part of your fantasy baseball season, which is the draft, the research for the draft, the actual 3-hour sit-down of doing it. And, you know, if you play your cards right, you can have a wonderful trophy like this right over here. That's my first place finish in one of my leagues last year. Should be noted that even a blind squirrel can find a nut once in a while, and if you're wondering, that is a Coors can there on a softball trophy. I just want to state for the record, with Coors Light, taste, the aesthetics, the value, I would give it 9 stars out of 53. So I think that's where I'm at with that. Anyhow, I hope you've enjoyed this little video snippet of what to do after a draft. And since I mentioned a nap in Pornhub.com, I will end it.